Hi everyone and welcome back. So here we are starting our development. Okay, we will start API separately and here we are starting the UI development and we are going to use Next.js, which is a server-side rendering framework with React.js. Okay, we are still going to write React.js component, but here we are doing a server-side rendering of our React component to make our application look faster in sense of rendering from server side. Okay, so I have already baseline my application. We'll talk about it. It's just a basic Next.js boilerplate, okay, which you can just get or you can just create just by using the Next.js CLI. Okay, here what we are going to do is let's talk about these one by one. So here we have our React.js. React.js is the framework which we are using. Okay, so this is our React.js. Okay, and on top of that there is a Next.js. I will just move it to back. This is our React.js. okay, so what it is enabling, it is enabling us for server side rendering. So if you see, this is the browser. If we say that this is the browser, then this Next.js is creating the bundle, final bundle, which is compiled and sending it to the browser, so that browser doesn't need to compile it back and lot of things. So whenever the initial rendering is faster in terms of when we talk about server side rendering, this is SSR. Whatever we do with the Create React app, that is a client side rendering. Okay, this is SSR, which we known as a server side rendering. Okay, so here we are using Next.js. There is one component, I mean this is actually a framework, Next.js, which is helping us to create a server side rendered routes, and we are creating components are still in the React. It's just like one another layer of framework which is helping us to create a server side rendered component. Okay, it is creating the final HTML and that HTML is getting rendered to our browser. So we are just sending the final compiled bundle and browser is happy to render that HTML. So rendering is faster when we talk about server side rendering. But in the client side rendering, browser have to do a lot of things, so initial rendering is slow. But when we talk about any e-commerce website and all, they all use server side rendering because it helps us to index the pages, create a unique indexes for search engine optimization. It also helps because when we create a single page applications, Google face troubles while indexing these pages and create a separate index for the crawler. Okay, but those things get resolved when we use Gatsby, Next.js. So there are a lot of framework. If I talk about this, you can use Gatsby. Okay, you can use this Next.js, which we are currently using, or you can also use one Vue.js framework, which is Next.js. I mean, I don't like the namings. I mean, they are all starting with an N. We have used, you already know Next.js. This is a framework for API backend. Then there is, I think, one more which also pronunciate like the same, which is Next. I mean, that is the ORM. But these frameworks, I don't like the naming convention because all look same. Okay, so this is what we are going to use, and we are going to use a generator on top of it. What generator will help us to create these small components, molecules, atoms. So there is a generator we are going to use. And we are going to use a plop as a library. Okay, plop is nothing but a library to create your template so that any new developer can create pages, components, templates, molecules and all. This is our server side rendered component. We are going to render it to the browser. And then you can see here we are going to query the GraphQL server, GraphQL API gateway. You can see this is a GraphQL. So before rendering, we will always have the data. So Next.js works in the different way. Here GraphQL will talk to the services to fetch the data. So that services we are going to write. The only additional thing we have to do is we can't just use Axios or HTTP to make a call. Okay, it's not like the interfacing layer will not be Axios. Here we are going to use GraphQL client. You can use GQL or you can use Apollo. These Apollo clients will make a query to the GraphQL. So here we are going to send a queries and mutation from Apollo client. Because this is a GraphQL server, we will do the query, we will get the data, we will publish it to the pages. And now, how these Next.js pages works, right? Let's go into the code and see. So here, SRC will directly go into the pages. These are the pages which indirectly becomes the routes in the application. So I have already created a separate series about Next.js, like how to create a server-side rendered pages. Whatever the pages you keep creating, you will be able to render them as a /route. Like if you do contact.js, JSX, your application will have a /contact, /about, /home, /index. All these routes will automatically get created. Okay. And this is the boilerplate, which I will directly provide you. You can clone it and you can start development with me. Okay. These are generators which will help you to create particular component. These are the handlebar templates, like you want to create HOC, you want to create a stateless components, functional component, all these things are available. So how to just do this? We have package.json. We can just do npm run generate. Okay, so it will give us the options. Okay, you want to create a page, templates, molecules, all these things. So this is the plop template. Select type, stateless functional component. What it should be called? Let's call it as a button. Okay, you want to, now this is our atomic design component, right? You want to create atom, molecule, organism on template. It should not be a template. It should just a simple atom. And now we are creating all these files. The components pack, the style.jsx, all these components. These components are automatically gets created. So whoever is developing, they will follow this standard. They will not violate this principle. They will always have a proper folder structure, spec file, test file, one snapshot file will be generated, a component file, and all these things. And when we do npm run dev, I will just remove this for now, which is created in the templates. Okay. Here, if we do npm run dev, this is how we actually start a Next.js application. Okay, it's already running, I think, 2004. We can just run it here. It's just a boilerplate. I need to fix few things. 2004, it started. Okay, now we should be able to see our application running. Okay, it has successfully compiled all the pages. So this is just a baseline of our application. Now we will start building on top of this. We are using a different stack. We are not just writing create React app, the client side rendering. We are using server side rendering here. We are using the Next.js with the React component. A lot of new things are here to learn. You will be able to learn how to do the integration with the Apollo GraphQL server. You will know how to write the pages using Next.js, how to write the React components using these generators, and how to do the testing, okay? And then how to get all these things running when we have a backend running, right? Now what we will do is we will just create a simple login and sign up pages with the simple header, and then we will do the integration with the Firebase, okay? So in the next video, let's get started with the component creation so we can have a basic layout, because with the Next.js, we also need to decide the layouts, okay? But because every page will have a header, footer, sidebar or something, so we have to constrain our layouts where the header footers will always be there on all the pages. Okay, let's do that from the next video. Thanks everyone.